it's an exciting report. I had the chance to look at some of the insights and some of the articles here. I thought something very interesting, and to call it the marketing reckoner, I thought was an appropriate name. And going forward, as we move into the changes of what the modern marketing and helping shape the future would be, I think this helps position that very well for India.
Yeah, I echo that. And in fact, some of the learning and insights has been quite interesting, especially in these times, right?
Yeah, COVID times.
Yeah. So, how have you been, Dipali? All good?
All good. Very, very busy. I think both consumers and organizations are going through a time of change and doesn't seem to be ending. I think that's the new reality.
Yeah.
Very, when you say future is unpredictable, I think that is what has come home to all of us now. We're still waiting for Tushar to come in.
That's right.
Okay.
Shall we get started?
Maybe yeah, let's start then. Okay, great.
Yeah.
First of all, many thanks to Dipali and Rohit to join the panel. Especially in these times, we're getting used to all the virtual panel, right? there could be some technical delay to everybody who's part of the, is participating, viewing the panel and listening to us. But we'll make it more interesting for all of you. Before we get to the panel, I thought let me just set, the context, right? So let me introduce the topic and share my initial thoughts, and then we can have an interesting discussion with all the panelists. The MMA annual report launch partnership with GroupM this year is titled The Modern Marketer Reckoner. This report has been conceptualized keeping in mind the business and the ecosystem situation in 2020. Several marketers were spoken to, and the key theme that emerged as a point of concern was the uncertainty which exists currently, and therefore how to navigate that. Therefore, we put together a report which essentially does two things. One is it captures the uncertainty and the changes which happened in 2020 at various levels, which is section one of the report that is titled as Nothing is Uncertain. The second one, it provides a modern marketing reckoner to marketers on the key strategic tentpoles they should look at, so to navigate the ambiguity and the uncertain business and economic landscape. This is section two of the report, and it is titled as Everything is Possible. When I was going through the report, it is quite holistic, and it brings in essentially that uniqueness. It also covers a wide range of topics, ranging from the social culture impact of COVID to impact on media consumption to changing shopping behaviors. Well, it also explores strategic tentpoles for marketers like real-time consumer insights, MarTech, content and creativity, marketing ROI, changing distribution models, and brand safety. What I felt is even more exciting is that this brings to you the minds of the best in the industry. In the report, you will contain the POVs from 20 plus industry experts and MMA board members in the many areas mentioned. You will also have, get to see some of the POVs from the group and leadership as well as the subject matter experts. So that is a quick snapshot of this, setting the context on the report. Now let us move into discussion with our panelists waiting there, now that we have Tushar also, right? So great, once again, welcome Dipali, Rohit and Tushar. Let me start my, the first interaction with, let me start with Dipali, right? So Dipali, these have been special time, right? And we also, one question keep coming in everybody's mind is, while most people believe that back to normal is probably at least 4 to 6 months away, some also believe that maybe it is a year away, right, getting to normal. What are your thoughts as a marketer, and how do you want to react to it?
No, PK, I think it is extremely important that marketers stop asking this question of crystal gazing and saying, is it 2 quarters away, is it 4 quarters away, or is it 6 quarters away? Because I think every market is going to react differently to it. I mean, I'm part of the APAC leadership team on marketing, and when we look at Australia, it's a different context. Korea is a different context. You know, GCG China for us is a different context. Singapore is different, and India is different, right? And I think what is the reality for all of us is that let's just look at next quarter and the next. Let's just keep ourselves ready for the next 6 months. Let's take decisions of imagining that the circumstances are going to be similar in the next quarter as they are today, and take decisions, and then come to the quarter after that. I think whether it comes to spends, whether it comes to ROI, whether it comes to deciding marketing tactics, we have to therefore what I call be truly agile in the way we work, in the way we take decisions. I think if you are used to doing a cycle only of a year-long annual plan, then it is time to break it into a quarterly cycle. I don't think anyone can predict it. And I also think that it should be very easy for marketing teams to do it. I think we've been very agile for a very long time. I mean, we've seen the shifts that have happened, whether it is usage of digital marketing over a five-year period, whether it is within digital marketing, some publishers working for us or not, when programmatic came in, we did a lot of shift that time. So we're all used to shifts. I think just the mental makeup of not being able to plan for the next 12 months is a psyche that we need to move away from.
Okay, I mean, thanks for for that advice to a lot of marketers, where agility in marketing plans, right, and adapting to step by step is extremely critical here, right? As well as I think looking at how we can move from quarter to quarter is a great great advice. So thanks for that, Deepak. We all are in a competitive world, and Rohit, this one is to you, right? And you get a chance to see across the world, you get chance to see in deep with multiple markets, and the question is, what according to you is a brand should do to stay connected with their consumers, especially in these times, right?
It's thank you for that, PK. I think there are a couple of things. Let me start with first and foremost, to echo what Dipali was saying, that we are living in times which are either quarter by quarter, month by month, based on whatever the preferences are and howsoever the marketers are looking at it. But when we spoke to several marketers, the key themes that we were able to drive, and I do this across China, which is a completely open market and there's no COVID that's happening there, and we are doing everything that needs to be done as if business was running in 2019 or before, to a market like India, which is starting to build on the COVID and starting to work around COVID, because this is there for certain. And this uncertainty of the times that we are living in is something that every brand has managed to comprehend. They've understood it, and they're willing to work on it. I don't think so there's anybody who's either dismissive or arrogant, if you will, to say that we don't know and we are not sure whether it can be done. And therefore, the tagline of our mobile marketing reckoner is nothing is certain and everything is possible. I think really lends itself to that question that you are asking, PK, is around the world, we've seen the worst, but we've also come out the best and on the top with certain marketing challenges, certain marketing, etc. And it captures the uncertainty of the changes that were there in the business. And what it also helps to provide, as you can see on the screen, the modern marketing reckoner screen, it also is our discussion with close to about 50 contributors to build this document, along with MMA and Group M, but we also got contributions from a lot of marketeers. And those marketeers clearly have stated in all of their experience that it is holistic in terms of the impact that COVID has had. And we have learned from this to explore what those strategic tent poles will be for marketeers in the and the consumer insights, if you will. Content or creativity, marketing or ROI, whatever you look at it. And it, it therefore becomes very important to understand the challenges that these marketers have posed to the industry on the whole. And as MMA, our effort is to really make sure that the industry comes together to help deliver on some of these challenges, work together for the marketers to build on these challenges, and then have solutions that we believe truly will solve what the modern marketing will be in days to come and what the future of this business will be. And definitely digital is leading that as we speak. And a lot of the marketers are doing that as we speak. So, and PK, if you give me permission, I do want to launch the first poll at this point in time, which I had created. The poll was around the question that you have, somewhat related to that, and the poll will come on the screen anytime soon, is what do the marketers really want? Is this something that matters to them? So the questions that we have on the poll, which will be coming on for the contributors to answer, is what matters most to a marketer? Attribution, brand safety, ad fraud, or ROI? So and this is based on the discussion, again, on all the discussion that we've had with the people, and we understand that these are all important elements for all of us. So I would say the representation of the answers and the notes in the Ready Reckoner, Mobile Marketing Reckoner, would be very helpful for the audience and for the industry as a whole. And I do see PK seem to have dropped off at this point in time, and he's not on the stage. So why don't I kind of take over from him for the moment and go on to the next part, if you will, on bring in Tushar there. PK is back, so I don't have to bring in Tushar.
I'm so sorry.
No worries.
I could hear you, everything. Anyway, thanks for that. And, you know, Tushar, as Rohit, you were mentioning, let me get Tushar into it. Yeah. Tushar, it's been a very unprecedented year, right? 2020 has been a year of a lot of flux and every way possible, right? The growing importance of mobile marketing during this pandemic and, you know, how a few would have stood out in this field. Can you shed some light on that, please?
Sure. Thanks, PK, and hello, everybody. So fortunately, I've been sort of associated with MMA for a long time. And let me go back a bit in time. So, and Rohit, you might remember, 2015, we have launches in a similar forum. We spoke about no mobile, no marketing.
Yes.
And that was a sort of a bold statement that time, right? So, and you can see the fire down the line. Things have changed, and things have changed drastically. Mobile happens to be the largest medium, not in terms of depth, but even in terms of time spent and type of consumption and width of consumption, which is happening, right? So there's, it's just no more a secret that as far as the India internet goes, it's a mobile internet predominantly. And if you look at COVID period, there is a huge amount of tailwind which happened in terms of consumer adoption. And we can sort of go on in terms of type of behavior change happened. But broadly, you can say there are many new habits which has emerged, and there are many habits which has got accelerated, right? So areas like commerce and stuff. But what I want to focus in this couple of minutes is more in a context of marketing and four area which sort of stands out of here, and I'd like to highlight 4 points here. One thing which has changed is focus on consumer journey. And fortunately, for marketers, the consumer back in focus. So it's no more medium, but consumer understanding consumer, understanding data around consumer, and then making decisions. So that's a changing, and I see this as a sort of long-term change. More journey, touch point, and then sort of right vehicle selection in those areas, right? So that's the one change I see. Second I see is basically acceleration of e-commerce. Specifically, I would like to highlight it's not only sort of adoption, but the basket and newer category got added to the e-com bucket, right? So your shopping basket got wider, number of items has sort of increased, number of new categories got added. So, and like to call out two sort of sub trend, which is going to be very important. One is the omni channel commerce has become sort of mainstay, and it's again going to grow whatever you call it, omni channel or the new retail. And the second area is social commerce. So again, it sort of started growing and it will continue to grow within that. The third point I would like to highlight is jugalbandi between content and influencer. And we have seen multiple interesting work which has happened during the COVID time. And that has become completely a new channel. And eventually the commerce will start getting added to it. And in some pocket, it already started getting added to it. So jugalbandi between content, influence, and commerce is, again, interesting area. And it will open up a whole lot of new opportunity. And finally, hyperlocal and location. Dipali touched upon sort of market. But when you look at within the market, it's going even deeper, right? And many marketers are thinking, not only social culture region, but even pin code level, because in a way pandemic has forced marketer to think that way in terms of impact of COVID and how the economy opened up during that phase. So planning at a pin code level, planning at a micro market is here to stay, and many activity, many prioritization, budget, all this will start getting allocated based on that. So and these are the four highlight I want to give, but as Rohit has mentioned, there's extensive detail which is got covered in the report.
If I may just add to that, I think there was a session yesterday which I was listening to, which Bessie Lee was talking about the social commerce in China and how luxury brands and others are looking at. To Shah's point, commerce is really going to be a big driver. And all this while marketers have always been trying to justify why digital, how digital, I think the attribution angle and the ROI angle is now in the last 6 months have been proven like never before, and it's scientific, it is data which is irrefutable. And I think Tushar has hit the nail on the head by saying that is going to be a key driver as we move forward for everybody.
Yeah, Rohit, the why question is almost disappeared, right? It's now the question is how and what. So yes. I don't think you nowadays you get why question anymore. So.
Yeah.
Great. That is very insightful. I could see the jugalbandi also happening. So very interesting. So great. So we had Dipali initially talking about how we got to be adaptive. We had Rohit talking about a few ways in which brands could stay connected with consumers. Then we had Tushar talking about different aspects that we have been seeing. Different areas that is actually growing importance now. All this actually brings to the next, probably a very important question, and this I think I should ask the marketer, right, in the panel, which is, so ROI, it is an important aspect, right, and especially now we see, since brands do different ways to reach the audience, what are your views, on the same, especially given these very evolving times, Dipali?
PK, I think ROI has earned the seat on the table for the marketeers, not just during COVID times, even pre-COVID. I think what has become very apparent to a lot of marketeers during COVID is that ROI is where they will stay alive, within an organization, as I call it. Imagine that organizations and companies are struggling for cash flows. They are going to therefore prioritize the most important investments. That could sometimes be technology, for building digital experience. That could be technology for cybersecurity. That could be technology for remote working. But they will, of course, invest in marketing, the one that delivers ROI. if you have to look at human mind, if you have to look at the mind of the leader and the CEO, and you know, who has to ensure that his organization survives, he will look at spend which deliver ROI to him. Having said that, that's if I look at that as a global principle, I think there are different categories. When you look at e-commerce, and whether it is, you know, social commerce like Tushar spoke about, whether you're looking at a small store who may have turned to Instagram the first time around, he's actually going 100% into marketing because that's the only way that he can get business into his store or sell, you know, online. So that is extreme example of ROI-driven marketing, where every dollar that you're spending, you're actually, you know, then saying, what am I getting out of it? The second is certain brands which, by virtue of the categories that they are in, do not have to justify, you know, the marketing spends. Amul is an example. I think as a category, they've done a dramatically good job in ensuring that India doesn't go hungry. You know, and I have said that to Mr. Sodhi personally, you know, and said that, you know, you've done a remarkable job over there. Now, if Amul as a brand, given the equity that they've had for, you know, many, many years, decide to invest some part of the, you know, marketing into actually creating better experience, better distribution, reaching more consumer, I think that part of the authenticity of the brand, you know, will come through. So the meaning of ROI also changes. There are certain brands who will still look at the ROI as I look at in a B2B domain and in a tech spend, you know, brand, which is to say I invest $100 and, you know, what's the business I'm getting out of it. However, there'll be certain brands which where growth is not an issue, you know, whether be it OTT channels, be it certain technology firms, you know, be it FMCG food, you know, they will look at ROI from marketing in a different fashion. So the definition of ROI changes across categories is the way I would leave the thought just now.
Okay, that's quite interesting. In fact, you know, these are also evolving, you know, category to category, right? And there are goals and how we look at those goals and how we apply them, and therefore how we make it more meaningful, right? For each.
However, I do want to add, PK, that I think if you look at it from the industry perspective and the ecosystem perspective, I think the marketing service providers need to think that there will be a shift. This is my personal prediction. There will be a shift from what we call the non-ROI related spends to ROI spends, because ROI spends will just become more essential from a business driven perspective.
Fantastic. So that's a good way to, you know, look at this entire channel of ROI and how marketers look at it. Yeah, so obviously, you know, when we are looking from ROI perspective, and which means looking at more objectively, looking at few of the data points on that. Tushar, this is to you. You know, while we are, I mean, especially during this pandemic and, you know, especially during these times, we are witnessing evolving practices, right? For example, data and insights are becoming, you know, an important lens for a constant check. What's your perspective? You know, what's your view on this, especially during these times?
Yeah, let me answer in a couple of parts. So there is a sort of macro level data, and then there is a consumer data, and then related entire conversation around ROI, right? So if you look at during COVID, macro level data, for example, like what we converted is more like a dashboard kind of thing to understand and decode what is happening around. Like, so we looked at consumer trend, we looked at content consumption, we looked at even mobility and location data. So how many people are stepping out, what's the traffic, what's air quality index. So basically we looked at multiple signal to understand and decode sort of various location, various consumer behavior, and then sort of build a right recommendation in terms of what to do. But if you look at the broader level consumer, I think what is happening in last sort of few quarters or few years is the dimension of data available is drastically changing, right? And there is a multitude of possibility which is opening up, starting from consumer behavior data to government data. So there is a broader data democratization opening. There's more avenues are opening up. However, in the mobile context, I would like to highlight two areas in which mobile contributes hugely in terms of driving the richness of data. So one is behavior data, second location data. And that's a very, very important sort of for any marketer today. And I almost go up to saying this, location is more like a new SEC as far as the marketing goes. So if you go deeper into that, and I spoke about full funnel, Dipali also spoke about the accountability. So the data to drive the full funnel understanding, data to drive consumer journey understanding and accountability, those linkages are going to be very important. More and more brands will start sort of learning from the first party data. So understanding their core consumer, understanding first party is becoming a more mainstay, and that will become a new know your consumer sort of activity. Next thing is, and sort of I would like to put, is actionability and agility. So focus is more on the actionable inside, not just inside, but what can I do? How quick I can act on the insight or data is going to be very important. So actionability and agility. And I would like to highlight one watch out here. So many times, basically, there's a gap between the agility and real time. So real time, it can be often, there is a trap there. But agility and a strategy because of the real time data is the right way to approach in my mind. And finally, role of technology in terms of technology driving some of the analysis, so AI, ML kind of thing, and helping us make a quicker decision, better predictions, so all is going to be important. And I'm going to overlay with a responsible way of using data, and I'm sure the next session is going to cover, so we'll not go there, but that's a table stack when it comes to using data.
Great. So there are lots in this, right? So carefully looking at how creating a data stack and carefully using them intelligently, you know, applying and leveraging the insights, I mean, it's all a part of that, right? Yeah. And especially in evolving times, you know, the more we're able to simplify this for every marketer and simplify and use it, I think it'll become a strong, strength for each organization, right? Great, thank you, Tushar. Maybe this leads to the next point, which is I thought, let me ask this to Rohit, right? And we have seen increased attention to all the digital investments, right, as well as continuous attention to offline activities, right? Something has been going on for some time, especially in India for the last couple of years. But now in these special times, only the accelerated attention is only on digital is only going up. However, there are offline activities happening. Why is it necessary for any brand to have an online-offline integration in today's world? Do you think it's important? What are your views on it?
Yeah, I think it is. And we've touched upon the fact that commerce is important. Tushar just mentioned that the new SEC is the data pin code, etc., whatever, howsoever we look at it. I think what is really important is we spoke a lot about data, but we tend to forget something which is very important. This data is actually all belongs to the consumer. And what happens is that we start to look at that from a perspective of a marketeer, an ROI-driven or engagement-driven. So how I can bring my online asset closer to the consumer in an offline world, which is a very seamless way of doing it. But the more that we do, more we do of that, the more we accumulate that information. It is also, I think, equally a responsibility on part of the marketeer and as well as the consumer of how that data is being looked at, how that is being treated, and how that is being served. Because if done properly, to your point, PK, the continuous evolution of this business will only become better if it does not jeopardize the basic ethos of privacy or issues around data privacy, etc. Now, if you were able to connect the offline to the online world, there's a very old saying, I don't even know, before I was born, which says 50% of the advertising dollar, we don't know where it gets spent. Those 50% of the dollars are now being tracked. Every penny can be tracked when it is digital. And if that can lead the consumer back to offline, and you can make an attribution connection between an online advertising marketing effort and translate that into the dollars spent at a store near your house, there's no way anybody can debate the challenge the viability of an O2O scenario, offline to online or online to offline scenario. But it needs to be dealt with and built with the conscious nature that it resides on, which is the data is a very important asset. It is the most important asset as we move go along in the future, and how well it is treated. Because the marketer who doesn't treat that data well will not be spared by the consumers. That we know. This is a new world, the emerging world, and online to offline, offline to online is the future for that.
Thank you, Rohit. In fact, you know, in this quick 30 minutes, we actually try to spend some time looking at various multiple ways of how a marketer should travel through this uncertain times. And some of it, you know, also went on from being adaptive to looking at different ways to connect with consumers, to look at how data and, you know, insights are critical from an ROI perspective, right, including online, offline perspective. And, you know, it looks like we have almost run out of time, right? So otherwise, this conversation, we could have gone and on. So a big thank you. You know, actually, this current wave of uncertainty and ambiguity, it becomes even more critical for marketers to measure ROI and therefore invest in data and technology to do the same, right? I would like to give a big shout to everyone. This report not only brings forth analysis and observation, but also the best of the minds in the industry, with several expert POVs from industry experts, MMA board members, as well as group of leadership and specialists. So please make sure you get your copy. Once again, I would like to thank the team and to all the people who are listening in. It's been a pleasure hosting all of you, and there has been learning as well. I hope we have given each one of you something to go back with. Many thanks, everyone, and stay safe. Thank you, Deepali. Thank you, Rohit. Thank you, Tushar. And
Thank you, everybody. And on behalf of MMA, I would like to really call out all the contributors. Deepali, you yourself are a contributor on this report, so thank you for that. And a lot of the other people, 50 other people, please download your copy of the report. It's going to be available on MMA website, and also we will share it to all of the people who have logged in and registered with us. There are a couple of thousand people, so please do download this. Gives you a good insight of what the future is, has been built, keeping in mind what the COVID challenges are, has been done during that time. So there's a good mindset and a good view of that. So appreciate your support, PK and Tushar, to help build this. And this has been a long-term partnership between the two organizations. So we really appreciate that and support that. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.